Hey, what up guys, Junako here. Today, Microsoft Gamescom Press Conference 2015. Let's go for it!
Deutschland. Herzlich willkommen zum Xbox Briefing im Rahmen der Gamescom 2015. Live aus Köln. Ich möchte die Gelegenheit jetzt nutzen, mich bei allen Entwicklern, Publishern, Medien und Xbox-Fans zu bedanken, die den Weg nach Köln gefunden haben, um heute bei uns zu sein. Und natürlich auch ein herzliches Willkommen an alle Zuschauer im Stream und auf Xbox Live zu Hause. Wir haben heute ein paar tolle Neuigkeiten für euch dabei. Lasst uns ohne Umschweife anfangen. Bitte heißt gemeinsam mit mir auf der Bühne herzlich willkommen Phil Spencer.
Thanks, Gregor. On behalf of everyone at Team Xbox, it's great to be here in Cologne, Germany for Gamescom 2015. This is one of the largest game expos on the planet, and we're energized by the nearly 400,000 passionate gamers, game developers, publishers, and industry professionals from Germany, Europe, and around the world, all here with a shared purpose: to take the art and technology of gaming to a whole new level. With the community of gamers as our motivation and inspiration, Team Xbox strives to deliver on our vision for gaming. That vision includes the games you want to play and the connection to the people you want to play with across the devices you want to play on. Whether you're a console gamer, a PC gamer, or both, we are committed to delivering the experience you expect from Microsoft. Throughout today's briefing, we will show you how your gaming and entertainment experiences on Xbox and Windows is getting better by the innovation and investment in gaming hardware and accessories, in the social connection with the world's premier gaming community on Xbox Live, and of course, the most anticipated games. I want to acknowledge that one of those games, Rare Replay, launched today. Rare Replay represents three decades of hit games and iconic franchises across multiple gaming platforms. The work Rare has done on the compilation is a testament to their heritage and creativity as a studio, and their commitment and dedication to the fans of Rare games. Rare Replay officially kicks off the greatest games lineup in Xbox history, a roster of exclusive games coming to Xbox One this year. And today, we will show you how this game lineup of games is getting even better in 2016. A couple of years ago, I stood on stage at E3 and I spoke about our growing investment in first-party studios and franchises. We are seeing the results of that investment in a diverse portfolio of exclusive games coming this year and next. And I remain committed to growing the exclusive franchises on both Xbox One and Windows 10. Our next three games join Sea of Thieves, Gears of War 4, and ReCore in the 2016 lineup announced at E3 in June. So let's get started. I've been a fan of Remedy games for many years, and I've had the privilege to work with them on their last two franchises. I believe they are building their greatest game yet. Let's take a look at Quantum Break.
Xbox One exclusive.
The number one killer is time. It destroys us all. When Paul came back, he came back wrong. Older, changed. He took away the only person who could stop the end of time. Will. My brother. Paul's men from Monarch are trying to stop me. Thing is, when time broke and changed Paul, it changed me too. Time's skipping. It's getting stuck, caught in violent loops. It's getting worse. Everyone freezes except me. Monarch has tech to keep going when time breaks. Paul knew this was coming. He's not trying to stop it. Maybe he even made this happen.
This could have all been avoided.
Well, Will's here, even when he's gone. A puzzle trapped in broken time.
Universe is a singularity. There should be no sound, no light.
Glimpses of the first prototype time machine, the origin of time travel. Something went horribly wrong here, but it's scrambled. It's impossible to crack.
Come with me. We can survive this together. Give me the device.
Don't do it, don't!
What if you're wrong?
No!
Please welcome, from Remedy, creative director, Sam Lee.
Hello, Gamescom. Quantum Break is the next big step on Remedy's 20-year journey of crafting cinematic, story-driven action games. In Quantum Break, two different elements, the game and an in-game live-action show, are fused together to form an entertainment experience that's more than the sum of its parts. Here with me today is Hollywood actor and one of the X-Men, Sean Ashmore.
Thank you, Sam. Thrilled to be here. I play Jack Joyce, who with his newly gained superpowers fights to stop the end of time. The game is about the heroes, the show is about the villains, and one story is told from multiple perspectives.
Our goal is to combine a heart-pounding action game with a live-action in-game show into something totally new and unexpected. You will see a lot more of Quantum Break this week at Gamescom. Before we leave, we have a trailer of the show to give you the full picture of the time-bending experience that is Quantum Break. Thank you.
Thanks, Gamescom.
Boom. Happened to the past. Tried to change things. Undo mistakes. Only to find there's no changing the inevitable. Time is just a closed loop. No matter what I do, you and I end up here. And no matter what I do, time ends.
Please welcome from Reagent Games, Creative Director Dave Jones.
Thank you. Crackdown has always been about innovation in open-world gaming. By bringing verticality, over-the-top player abilities, and four-person co-op to the genre. Now, open world means go anywhere and do anything. And while we're set to deliver a massive new city for you to play in, it's the... It's the anything part of that vision where we're working to set a new bar. Today, we're taking you behind the scenes at Reagent Games to show you the vision, the in-engine gameplay, and the technology that is the foundation for our game and the foundation for how we will change the way you play games forever. This is Crackdown 3.
Xbox One exclusive.
Some people look out on the city and just see lights. I see lives, Agent, burning with hope for a better future. But what happens when evil comes out of the shadows? We do what we always do. We go to work.
The team at Reagent Games is proud to bring you our vision of the ultimate sandbox. Explore the heights of a futuristic city. Race through the streets in a transforming vehicle. And use your powerful abilities to stop a ruthless criminal empire. Crackdown 3 delivers the classic gameplay in a brand new way. Crackdown 3 is set in a dangerous new city. A once glistening metropolis overrun by violent crime and corruption. Life in Gangland is an intricate web of dangerous interconnections. A dynamic ecosystem with multiple moving pieces. A criminal hierarchy to be dismantled any way you choose. Crackdown 3 will blow up the way you play games today by introducing a revolutionary new multiplayer experience using 100% destructible environments. By connecting to the Microsoft Cloud, play with 20 times the computational power of your Xbox One and experience unrelenting destruction and mayhem. It's not just what you can do with a gun. It's the opportunities you can create with destruction.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Platinum Games, game director Hideki Kamiya.
Hello. Scalebound is the biggest game we've ever made at Platinum Games, an action RPG where you can freely explore a vast, mysterious world on foot or on the back of a majestic dragon. You play as the young man from Earth named Drew, who, along with the dragon Tuban, have been searching for a powerful artifact. To succeed, they'll need to fight through the soldiers of an evil empire and even more dangerous foes. I'm excited to show you Scalebound gameplay for the very first time. Welcome to the world of Draconis.
Xbox One exclusive.
It's almost time to rejoin the main unit.
That's right. The carrier ship will arrive in about an hour.
Good. Huh?
It's more of them than I expected. You're up, big guy. Yeah, what the hell was that for? I'd get off if you'd ask me to. Use your words.
I've never seen a creature like that before. Don't panic. Team, unite up.
Oh, man. Here we go. Oh, yeah? Well, maybe you should hide behind me. All right, let's go.
Intruder! Over there!
Wreck it! Let's head that way. Mantis, must have heard you thrashing around. Let's stop this guy.
Thank you.
mystery. Come on, let's get out of here before any of his friends show up.
Ladies and gentlemen, Head of Platform Engineering, Mike Ibarra.
Thank you. It is great to be here at Gamescom. You've just seen a few of the amazing games coming in 2016. In addition to playing great games, our fans are also passionate about their entertainment. A year ago, we gave you more choice by bringing a new capability, especially meaningful to the fans here in Europe, free-to-air HD television on Xbox One. We've been listening to your feedback, and many of you have asked, will I ever be able to record live TV? Today, I'm pleased to announce the answer is yes. We're adding full-featured DVR functionality to Xbox One. You can record free-to-air TV, schedule recordings, and take your shows on the go. Let me show you how easy it is. From the One Guide, I can quickly select the show I want to record and get back to watching TV or playing one of my favorite games. Xbox records my show in the background without impacting my experience at all. With Instant On enabled, it will record my shows even when I'm not at home. Getting access to all of my recordings is easy. Within the One Guide, I just go to the DVR section and I can see all of my shows. DVR will be even better with the Xbox app on Windows 10. All shows you have recorded on Xbox One can also be streamed to any Windows 10 device in your home, be it a tablet, a laptop, or a phone. Even better, you can also download shows to your device, so you can watch them on an airplane, on a bus, really anywhere, even without an internet connection. Because our DVR is powered by Xbox Live, you can also schedule recordings even when you're on the go, and they'll show up back on your Xbox One. Best of all, this is a subscription-free service, and it's coming in 2016. We've also been hearing you ask for an easier way to message with friends. And today, I'm excited to announce the new Xbox Chat Pad. Now you can quickly compose messages, enter codes, and search for games and apps. You also get audio controls at your fingertips and a stereo jack for your headset. The chat pad also comes with two new programmable keys. I'm personally looking forward to taking screenshots and recording game DVR clips at the touch of a button. The chat pad is compatible with all Xbox One controllers and works with both Xbox One and Windows 10. It will be available in November, and you can pre-order today. At E3, we also announced the ability to play Xbox 360 games on your Xbox One. Since then, we have been humbled by the response. In just over a month, the Xbox community has submitted more than 3 million votes, and preview gamers have played over 83 years of Xbox 360 games on their Xbox One. I'm happy to announce that all future Xbox 360 games with gold titles will be backward compatible at launch. This means Xbox One and Xbox Live Gold members get more free games to play each month. At Xbox, our first-party Microsoft Studios are committed to backward compatibility, allowing you to play your top Xbox 360 franchises like Halo, Gears, and Fable on your Xbox One. Combined with support from leading third-party publishers such as EA, Bethesda, Ubisoft, 2K, and many more, I'm excited to announce backward compatibility will be available for everyone for free this November, with over 100 games and hundreds more to come. In addition to backward compatibility, in November, we're updating Xbox One with Windows 10 and releasing a completely redesigned experience that will be faster and easier than ever before. November is going to be a great time for Xbox fans. Thank you, and have a great week here at Gamescom.
Ladies and gentlemen, General Manager Microsoft Studios, Shannon Loftus.
In my 20 years of making games for Microsoft, rarely have I seen a community as engaged and vibrant as the Killer Instinct community. Thank you. At E3, we announced KI is coming to Windows 10. Anything you own in KI, you'll own on both platforms, and we're supporting cross-platform play. And on Windows 10, all of your existing controllers and flight sticks will just work. Today, I'm excited to announce that Killer Instinct Season 3 is coming March 2016 to Xbox One and Windows 10. I'm also excited to announce that Killer Instinct will feature guest characters, and that KI and Rare Replay players can get a sneak peek of Rash from Battletoads. And he's coming today. Rash, show us what you got.
Please welcome the director of ID at Xbox, Chris Charla.
Hey, everybody. It's been 2 years since we launched ID at Xbox right here at Gamescom because of our belief in the power of independent games. Since then, we've been blown away by the creativity and innovation independent developers are bringing to Xbox. There are more than 1,000 studios creating games via ID at Xbox today, and it's awesome to see how many are also starting to take advantage of Xbox Live on Windows 10. In fact, every game I talk about today will ship on both Xbox One and Windows 10. So, to get things started, we want to talk about one game we've been excited about since it was announced this spring. I'd like to welcome to the stage a true master of game design. Please welcome the creator of Castlevania Symphony of the Night, Mr. Koji Igarashi, to talk about Bloodstained.
Hi, everyone. 本日ここに来ましたのは Bloodstained の Windows 10版にですね、コープモードに、コープモードでですね、Xbox One とのクロスプレイ機能が入ることをお知らせするためです。
Hello everyone, this is Iga. As you can see, he's still working on his whip-cracking skills. Today, it gives us great pleasure to announce cross-play functionality in the Xbox One and Windows 10 versions of Bloodstained Ritual of the Night.
Bloodstained はですね、Thank you. Bloodstained はですね、2.5D 横スクロールの探索型アクション RPG で、Kickstarter でですね、5.5 million 以上のですね、支援をいただいたタイトルになります。
For those of you who do not know, Bloodstained Ritual of the Night is a 2.5D side-scrolling action-adventure game with heavy RPG elements. It recently raised over $5.5 million on Kickstarter.
クロスプレイによってですね、Xbox One ユーザーと Windows 10ユーザーがですね、同時にプレイすることができまして、Bloodstained のですね、奥深い世界観をですね、より楽しく、体験することができます。
Crossplay will allow Xbox One and Windows 10 gamers to enjoy and explore the deep, vast, robust, and gothic world of Bloodstained together.
もう一つ、今回ですね、ちょっとしたサプライズを用意しました。
We actually have one other small surprise for you today.
新しいキャラを紹介します。
That one was a little bit better. A brand new character in Bloodstained.
このキャラクターですね、ちょっと急ぎで作ったので、ですね、名前とかいろいろまだ未完成のところがあるんですけれども、でゲームの設定の10年前にですね、召喚された悪魔たちを倒したデーモンハンターの一人です。
We're still putting the finishing touches on this character, so we don't actually have an official name yet, but we can say that this is a demon hunter that fights the demons that first come to Earth on an attack that occurs 10 years before Bloodstain the game begins.
主にですね、二振りの刀とお札を使って戦います。
We can also say that he is a dual sword welding hero that uses Japanese ofura spells to fight his foes.
今回マイクロソフトと組ませていただいてですね、このクロスプレイのような、画期的なですね、フィーチャーを提供できることが本当に今回嬉しく思っております。
And we're just really, really excited to be able to team up with Microsoft and prepare such an innovative, cutting-edge feature for all of our fans.
皆様がブラッドステインドを一日でも早くプレイできるようにこれから我々は頑張って制作していきます。
Thanks for everything, guys. We're working our best to try and get the game into everyone's hands as soon as possible.
Thank you very much.
Cheers.
Wow, that was awesome. As a backer of Bloodstained's Kickstarter, I am stoked. In the next 12 months, we'll have more than 150 games from independent developers launched through ID at Xbox, more than in previous years combined. And many of these games will be coming first to console on Xbox One.But no matter what kind of games you like to play, independent developers are bringing you amazing titles on Xbox and Windows via ID at Xbox. For example, City Skylines, the awesome new city builder from Paradox and Colossal Order, will be coming first to console on Xbox One in the next year. We'll also see a portfolio of games from simulation experts Dovetail Games, including their award-winning franchise Train Simulator, coming first to console on Xbox One.Daedalic Entertainment, a great German developer and publisher, is going to be bringing a portfolio of their independent titles to Xbox One and Windows 10 with Xbox Live as well. And our friends at Team 17 are continuing to help other independent developers ship great games on Xbox One and Windows 10. Today, they're shipping Beyond Eyes by Tiger and Squid on Xbox One.Later this year, they'll be bringing Escapist Walking Dead, a unique undead twist on the hit prison escape game.And last week, they announced they'd help bring the ukulele to console on Windows 10 as well. It's an amazing looking game with great character design, blue sky gaming. It's awesome. Can't wait. Team 17 is also hard at work on the next iteration of their most famous franchise, which adds some awesome new mechanics to what's already a great game. Let's take a look. That looks sweet. That game's gonna be awesome. So, one genre I've always been personally a huge fan of is adventure games. So it's an incredible honor to be able to introduce to you guys one of the genre's pioneers and a true gaming legend, the creator of Maniac Mansion and Monkey Island, Mr. Ron Gilbert.
Thanks, Chris.Now, when Gary and I launched our Kickstarter for a new point-and-click adventure game, we had two goals in mind. The first was for you to play a truly classic graphic adventure, and the second was for us to relive the nostalgia of making one of those games again. And now, with the dedication of Microsoft, Thimbleweed Park is going to be coming to Windows 10 and Xbox One. And here is a quick preview of Thimbleweed Park with the pixels so sharp they could poke your eye out.
Good. Thanks a lot, Ron. When we announced Xbox Game Preview at E3, we had an outpouring of interest from the development community who were excited to have players experience their games and provide feedback before their full release. Two games have released through the program so far, and we're excited to announce that Sheltered, Team 17's post-apocalyptic family bomb shelter simulator, is going to be available for download later today. Also, coming soon is a really cool dinosaur survival title, Ark Survival Evolved. It's going to be coming to Game Preview this winter and shipping next year on Xbox One and Windows 10. Let's take a look. Ark is looking fantastic, and it's really just the beginning. We've been going through a ton of concepts with our development partners, and today I'm excited to announce just a few of the titles that will be coming to the program in the next few months. We're going to get the first taste of Rivals of Aether, Dan Fornace's four-player online fighting game, later this year. And later this winter, fan favorite Starbound from Chucklefish will make its console debut in the Xbox Game Preview program. Finally, I'd like to leave you with one of the creepiest and coolest games we've seen in a long time. This game is going to be first on console on Xbox One next year, but you can experience it in Game Preview this holiday. Let's take a fresh look at We Happy Few from Compulsion Games. Thanks a lot.
London Bridge has fallen down. It's fallen down. Fallen down. London Bridge has fallen down. Take the keys and lock them up. Yes, go on, do it.
Lock them up. Yeah, lock them up.
Take the keys and lock them up.
My family.
Everything is quite all right. Sleepy tight. Nighty night, everything's coming out of sight. My fair lady.
Please welcome from Microsoft, Program Manager Jasmine Lawrence.
Thanks. Just last week, we began the worldwide launch of Windows 10. Now, I'm super excited about this launch because Windows 10 represents the best version of Windows we've ever made for gaming. It starts with great hardware and software. We've worked closely with our partners like AMD, NVIDIA, Intel, and others to ensure the best possible PC gaming experience. Windows 10 introduces DirectX 12, which gives game developers direct access to the graphics hardware, enabling them to deliver new levels of visual fidelity and performance for PC games. Over 100 game studios are actively developing DirectX 12 games, including Epic with Unreal Tournament and Stardux, Ashes of Singularity. And that's just the beginning. Director Tabata-san and the Final Fantasy team at Square Enix have put together a technology demonstration showing the incredible realism that DirectX 12 and Windows 10 make possible. Let's take a look.
Hmm.
DirectX 12 is just one of the ways that Windows 10 is built for gaming. As gamers ourselves, we knew it was important that the games and services that you use today work great and get even better on Windows 10, including League of Legends and Steam. So with Windows 10, you can easily record and share your favorite clips and screenshots from your PC games with the built-in game DVR. This means no additional hardware or software is required. And all Xbox gaming accessories are designed for both Xbox One and Windows 10. Windows 10 also brings Xbox Live to PC in a way that adds value for PC gamers. It starts with a built-in Xbox app, where you can see your friends, your games, and even voice and text chat from PC to PC and from PC to console. Xbox Live makes your PC games better with cloud saves that allow you to start your game on one device and continue your saved game on another. And starting with new games like Fable Legends and Gigantic, they'll have cross-buy so that anything that you purchase on one platform is automatically available on the other. But also cross-play so that you can play with or against your friends on Windows 10 and Xbox One. Now, if you have an Xbox One, Windows 10 allows you to stream your Xbox games to your PC from anywhere in your home network. Starting this year, many of our biggest Xbox franchises are also coming to Windows 10. Killer Instinct, Gears of War, and Rare Sea of Thieves, just to name a few. And as you just heard from Chris, we've got a great lineup of games from ID at Xbox, like Cuphead and Super Dungeon Brothers. See, you've just heard why we believe that Windows 10 is the best version of Windows we've ever made for gaming. So upgrade for free today and try it for yourself. Thanks.
Please welcome, from Mojang, lead developer Jens Bergensten.
Last Wednesday, we released a new version of Minecraft designed specifically for Windows 10. The Windows 10 edition is a beta, and will get better and better over time with the help of your feedback. All existing players of the current Java version will get the game for free by logging into the Mojang account. And one other thing we love about the Minecraft is the passion the community has for the game. We look forward to bringing a steady stream of updates and happy, many new things to play with this fall. Thank you for playing Minecraft and sharing your feedback with us. There's one more thing I want to share. I may be the lead developer of Minecraft, but I've also been working with two of my closest friends, Daniel and Pontus, on a new game called Cobalt. With Cobalt, we wanted to build something that we could play together with great couch multiplayer and a fun co-op adventure game. Now I'm excited to share with you that Cobalt is coming to Xbox as a console exclusive this October. Here's the first look at Cobalt for Xbox.
Xbox exclusive.
Say on pilgrimage. fades.
Of the new America on the horizon. Who'd like to say a few words of gratitude?
To our honorable and faithful leaders, I want to say thank you. Thank you for your kindness, generosity of spirit, and your concern for our future. At first, we rejected you, but that was because we did not understand. We didn't realize how much we needed you. We didn't appreciate that your arrival was a precious gift. Your presence has roused us from our complacency. We have awoken from our wasteful sleep and taken responsibility for our future. We have renewed pride in our work. We are once again enterprising, resourceful, and cooperative. Thanks to you, we have rediscovered who we are. And there's no turning back to our apathetic and misguided ways. A new day has dawned, and a brighter future beckons. And for this, we say, thank you.
Hi. I'm CJ, Senior Narrative Designer at Dambuster Studios. In Homefront the Revolution, we've taken an incredible premise, a fallen America occupied by a foreign power, and built an open-world shooter that puts the player in the role of a guerrilla soldier fighting for freedom. We're going to show you a brief glimpse of guerrilla warfare Homefront style from our single-player experience, which is playable here at Gamescom. But for Homefront the Revolution, we'll also offer a compelling cooperative multiplayer mode in which you and your friends can form a resistance cell and become heroes of the revolution. We're going to be working with Microsoft to test it out, and we're proud to announce today that Xbox One owners will enjoy exclusive early access to the Homefront multiplayer beta this winter. Thanks.
World premiere.
All cells across the zone are armed and ready. We just need the targets.
Dana here. We'll get you those locations. As soon as we can reach the KPA transceiver, we'll download the data.
Okay, Isaac, get up to that intersection. Make sure it's clear.
Sniper. Are you loose? Go!
producer, EA Sports FIFA, Nick Channel.
This season in FIFA 16, we're focused on three big things to create a beautiful football experience. We're innovating across the entire pitch to give fans balanced and exciting gameplay. And we're helping every fan compete at a higher level with FIFA Trainer, an all-new in-game training system. And finally, we're bringing new and exciting ways to play FIFA in your favorite modes. And for the first time ever, women's national teams are in our game. To build on this story of FIFA 16, I'm here to tell you about exclusive news for fans playing on Xbox. That news is all about two things, FIFA Ultimate Team and EA Access. FUT is the place fans go to live out their footballing dreams. It's the most popular mode in FIFA, played by millions of fans on any given day. And we all know Xbox players love their FUT. So what's coming this season? Only on Xbox, you'll have more FUT legends to create the ultimate squad. 60 new legends adding more iconic players. And we'll meet them soon. We're also making it easier for you to fit legends in your team with all new legends chemistry. Every player will match leagues with legends, and now you only need a pair nationality to create strong connections on the pitch. So if you're building a squad with legend Javier Zanetti at right back, he'll have a good connection with Rafael Varane, but an even stronger connection with his fellow Argentinian Leo Messi. This gives you more combinations to build that ultimate squad only on Xbox. And that is what you want, better squads and better players. And we'll start you on that path with massive news for fans playing on Xbox. We're giving a legend player on three-game loan to everyone who plays FIFA Ultimate Team on Xbox this season. Now I want to tell you about the benefits of EA Access. Members get to play first, play more, and play for less only on Xbox One. FUT fans, this is a big deal for you. EA Access members save 10% on FIFA Ultimate Team points, and you can put this to use when searching for that perfect legend. And members get to play first in FIFA 16. Get in the game up to a week early for a limited time before it even hits the shelves here on September the 24th. So this season, you can play first on Xbox One with EA Access. Play with EA Access and save up to 10% in FUT. And play with legends only on Xbox. Let's meet those new legends right now.
Oh, the stadium has won. Stands to applaud the fantastic talent.
Incredibly successful goalkeeper, Vitor Bahia. Great tackle from Gattuso. And Yari Littmanen is the scorer.
That was an elegant finish.
Well, he's a clever midfield player, Deco. Got the ball again. Such a strong tackler, Javier Zanetti.
Oh, that is silky smooth from the Welshman.
Real classic Italian defender, Alessandro Nesta. It's a goal from George Best.
Well, it's a privilege to see that kind of finish from what is a legend.
Thanks, Nick. We know how much our fans love playing FIFA, and we're excited to introduce the Xbox One FIFA 16 bundles. Both bundles include FIFA 16, three lone legends for your ultimate team, and EA Access, so you can play FIFA first on Xbox One. The FIFA bundles are available starting September 15th, and you can pre-order them today. Now let's take a look at more of the games coming in 2015. Joining FIFA 16 in the lineup is a franchise that launched the original Xbox, has defined multiplayer on Xbox Live, and serves as the cornerstone of our first-party portfolio. This is Halo 5 Guardians.
Xbox One exclusive.
Thank you.
double kill, maybe a trip. Yes, the triple kill. Brilliant plays out of him here in the winner bracket finals.
Just 85 days until launch.
Indeed. Super excited to get a little bit more hands-on with everybody else today. You know, Gamescom, going to be good.
Hey, me as well. Hey there, I'm Andy Bravo-Dudinsky, former Pro Halo coach, and joining me today is my European counterpart and esports shoutcaster, Richard Sims.
Thanks, Bravo. As we just saw, the Halo multiplayer legacy continues to evolve in Halo 5 Guardians, and today it's all about Arena. Arena is Halo's esports-focused 4v4 mode with even stats, an intense mix of Slayer and objective game types.
And in Arena, I think this new map that we're unveiling right now will be a top choice in tournament play moving forward. Let's take a look at Colosseum, which has everything that makes a great competitive Arena experience. It's a symmetrical two-base map, which includes a unique mix of elevation and sightlines, and it's purposely built for a wide variety of fast-paced multiplayer modes. Now, in anticipation of the Halo 5 Guardians Gamescom Invitational happening here at the ESL Arena, we invited two of the top Halo Pro teams in the world, Epsilon Esports and Optic Gaming, to play some preliminary matches at the 343 Industries headquarters in Seattle.
Let's talk a little bit about these two teams then, Bravo. Epsilon Esports is one of the best teams in all of Europe, made up of varying UK players, including the Buck Twins, Buck 57, and Buck 20, one of the winningest duos in European Halo. Now, Halo has predominantly been dominated by the North American team, so the question was, can Epsilon upset the balance and change the compass needle?
And that's it. And on the other side of the stage, we have fan favorites Optic Gaming from the US, led by Halo veteran Flamesword and the winner of the 2013 Halo 4 Global Championship, Ace. Now, these two teams have never played before, so of course, a lot of speculation on the line of who would come away with the ultimate victory.
Now, over the course of the visit, these two teams battled in match after match of intense competition. They all rounded up with a best of three series on Capture the Flag on the new map, Colosseum.
I have to tell you, Sims, I got a chance to see each and every one of these matches, and these two teams were neck and neck throughout the entire series, but it all came down to one last game.
You know what? Let's jump on back and take a look at some of the most clutchest moments of that final game.
All right, so we're going to be checking out, for the first time ever, Colosseum in Halo 5 Guardians. The game is going to be Capture the Flag, three captures to win, or the top score after 12 minutes. Our two teams in red will be Optic Gaming, and in blue, it'll be Epsilon Esports. Going to kick things off here with Flamesword off the break. But Sims, one of the first things you're going to notice are the player outlines here. Halo 5 Guardians has made some major investments in esports features, and some of that is giving players better camera and spectator tools to make sure they can tell the best story they can during a match. Take a look at this. Flamesword picks up the double kill.
And now we move across at the moment. It's Jimbo coming back on the defensive. He knows someone's in the cave. Grenade goes in. He spots Ace. Ace has got the sniper rifle. This will be a big kill, which he manages to get. The flag is there. However, he turns around. Spots Maniac, takes him down. Big double kill, and he gets the return as well.
Yes, big plays from Jimbo indeed. But on the other side of the map for Team Europe, it's Buck 20 grabbing the second overshield of the game for his squad, Epsilon Esports. He's going to use that to push into the enemy base and grab the first flag of the match. Take a look at that on your screen. Flag juggling has returned here in Halo 5 Guardians as Buck 20 escorts that flag all the way across the map and overshield in hand. He finally gets a little bit of late pressure though as he rounds this corner, but in doing so, Sims, Epsilon Esports will go up 1-0 with 10-20 left in the match.
Moving forward with Buck 20 again, he's back in Optic's base and just in their face as he pushes in. He finds assault half shield, takes him down, no problem, goes for the second pull of this match. Ace comes back for a little bit defensive, he thrusts out, and all of a sudden we see Flamesaw come out of nowhere, he gets taken down. Ace does come back for a little bit of a defensive shot. However, Buck 20 says no, he's going to run that straight out of the front bridge at the moment. As we see him moving forward, takes the flag, jumps, thrusts, toggles, and he managed to clamber up into the blue courtyard. He's going to run that forward. However, he's going to take some shots in the back, but that doesn't matter at all. He has his teammate sniped right behind him to get the collection.
Yeah, Epsilon Esports is going to go up 2-0, but let's take a look at that replay right there. Slow it down a bit. Look at that jump, toss, thrust, and clamber using those brand new Spartan abilities to escort the flag all the way across the map, and Epsilon Esports will secure that point and go up in the match 2-0.
Back on board with Jimbosity right now, putting some cracking shots across the map. Manages to land a headshot with the Magnum. Turns to his left, he's going to get some defense there. Finds Ace, grenade goes in. Will he clean up this kill? Yes, he does indeed, as he thrusts around the corner, finds Assault, takes him down, another big double kill for Jimbo.
But there's more in store for Jimbo here. Take a look at this. The Overshield power-up is about to drop. Here it comes. Boom! Lands the Spartan charge, stealing the Overshield out from underneath the Optic Gaming setup. Sims, we gotta run that back one more time. That Overshield power-up, so pivotal. But look at this. Jimbo with four enemy players on his screen. He swoops in here, landing that perfectly timed Spartan charge. Also uses the thruster pack to grab the Overshield. That's going to have Epsilon Esports continue their control of the bottom of the map. Now back into the match in real time. You see as Maniac is desperately trying to shut down Jimbo some way, somehow. He jumps up here, but Jimbo will land the punch to the face.
Coming off the spot now with Maniac. He's going to get himself at the moment. Yes, he does. He gets a punch himself. My sniper on half shield takes him down, grabs the sniper rifle. But you know what, Bravo? There's only 1 minute 30 remaining in the game.
Right.
He needs to make something happen, and he needs to do it now, which is exactly what he does. He's going to run that straight out the front bridge now, looking for some support from his teammates. But unfortunately, he just finds Jimbo. Jimbo again with another defensive return.
Too much defense here from Jimbo in the back left quadrant of his map. He's going to take one player out. Yes, indeed. Spots a second here on the second. And it's going to be an assist there. But spots a third and uses the ground pound stall. The pressure from Epsilon Esports is just too great. We switch over to Buck 20 in the last moments of the match, but the clock is ticking down, and Epsilon Esports will win the game 2-0 and win the final series with a score of 3-1.
Congratulations to Epsilon Esports on that incredibly clutch win. Europe takes this first round, showing the American teams that they have a little something to think about.
Oh, I think that is the case indeed there, Sims. I believe they have a little bit to think about. Like you said, North America, of course, usually on top, but bragging rights weren't the only stakes that these teams were playing for. Each player on Epsilon is walking away with this limited edition Halo 5 Guardian themed 1 terabyte Xbox One, complete with a matching controller, a console that will be available to the public, including the digital version of the game, on October 20th, so the players can pre-download and be ready for battle on day one. And Sims, that console is available for pre-order immediately following today's briefing.
I think we all better go home and get his pre-orders on. And remember, guys, you can catch Epsilon and Optic as well, some of the top European teams, on Friday for the Halo 5 Guardians Gamescom Invitational 2015 on the Halo channel, as well as twitch.tv/Halo.
That's right. We hope you'll join us. Before we go, let me welcome to the stage executive producer of Halo 5 Guardians, Josh Holmes. Thanks, everyone.
Thanks, Bravo. Thanks, Sims. And congratulations to Epsilon Esports on a big win. So Halo has always been synonymous with online competition and was an originator in console esports. With Halo 5 Guardians, we are fully embracing that legacy with the biggest investment in Xbox esports history. Get ready for the first ever Halo World Championship, coming this winter with a prize pool of over $1 million. Halo 5 Guardians is the biggest and most ambitious Halo game yet. New worlds, new heroes, and a story that takes our universe in new directions. We'll have much more to share with you in the months ahead. Until then, we have Arena and Warzone multiplayer on the show floor here at Gamescom. Thank you.
World premiere.
The town of Costa del Porto. Barnet! And when he comes to protect the insignificant, kill his friends.
Just Cause 3. Set the world on fire December 1st.
Ladies and gentlemen,
From Turn 10 Studios, Dan Greenewald.
. 2015 marks the 10-year anniversary of the Forza series. And in the decade since its first release, over 25 million fans have experienced the automotive world of Forza. Between the return of Porsche in Forza Horizon 2, our partnership with Fast and Furious, and the debut of the show-stealing Ford GT, 2015 has already been a great year for racing gamers. But this year is far from over. On the 15th of September, racers all over the world will get their hands on Forza Motorsport 6. The most beautiful, the most technically advanced, and the most comprehensive game we have ever built. In Forza 6, you'll race over 450 Forza Vista cars, twice as many as any other racing game this generation. And every car includes working cockpits, doors, and headlights, as well as full damage and customization. Armed with your favorite cars, tour 26 world-famous destinations, all built to the highest level of detail and realism. And through the power of Xbox Live, compete in epic 24-player races on dedicated servers. Here, all new ranked leagues deliver fast and fair competitive multiplayer. And in leagues, you'll be grouped into ranked divisions based on both your speed and your professionalism. Every week, new events are created for each division. Top racers against top racers for top prizes. In the new career, feel the claustrophobia of racing by headlight alone in the utter blackness of night, and the danger of competing in the rain as tires hydroplane across physically based 3D puddles. This is as real as it gets. Let's take a closer look.
Xbox One exclusive.
When it's time, we race rain or shine.
Joseph Newgarden is a ferocious competitor. He just won in Toronto while racing in wet weather conditions. Having his perspective really helped us deliver an experience that speaks to players of all types.
Racing in the wet, everyone calls it the great equalizer because it's the toughest conditions you're ever going to run in.
When we decided to do rain, we wanted to do it in an impactful, authentic way.
The brake lights,
the spray being surrounded by cars,
the way that the water shears off cars in front of you,
the windshield wiper in your face.
It's perfect.
We have 148 unique drivable surfaces.
Rumble strips, grass, gravel,
cement, tarmac. All of them had to feel unique.
There's a lot of different areas of the track that you have to make sure are correct.
Each with different values for wet and dry. We approached researching this in the most authentic way we could. Going through old race footage, doing our measurements on the track itself, we were able to recreate where every single puddle was placed.
I get to drive multi-million dollar simulators, and none of them that I've experienced have had wet conditions built into their model. So for Forza to be at the cutting edge of that is pretty cool.
And all rain is running at the speed of simulation, at 1080p and 60 frames a second with 24 cars on track. All of this wouldn't be possible without the Xbox One.
Forza Motorsport 6 has reached a new level. They are always pushing the boundaries, and I think they always deliver.
World premiere. gentlemen, from Crystal Dynamics, game director Brian Horton.
Hello, everyone. It's fantastic to be at Gamescom to present exclusive new gameplay from Rise of the Tomb Raider. Lara Croft is in a race to discover the lost city of Katesh and the secrets of immortality. A ruthless shadow organization known as Trinity seeks this power and will destroy anyone in their way. Lara will need to sharpen her skills to survive the overwhelming obstacles in her way.
Xbox exclusive.
We join Lara in the Geothermal Valley, a massive exploration space that is three times larger than any we've made before. You can spend hours here collecting and hunting resources, completing challenges, and discovering tombs. Rewards you earn help improve her gear and abilities. At base camp, Lara can upgrade her weapons, craft ammunition, and master new skills. You can customize Lara based on your preferences and playstyle. The valley below is guarded by Trinity forces, and you must decide how to defeat them.
They think might know something about the Atlas. Constantine's gonna ask them a few questions. They've got the rest back up near the cathedral.
Someone's gonna have some fun stuff.
That must be them.
This much opportunity?
Company men are acting antsy out here. Usually they're all business.
Something about the judge.
What's that?
Something they can tell us.
Can't say.
Once we finish scrubbing this site, you men can head on out to the rest of them.
So what are we looking for exactly?
Command thinks the Atlas beneath the field. We're looking for anything that might confirm. I'll take a look.
Like what exactly?
If we knew... What was I saying? Oh, right. If we knew, you wouldn't be looking. Documents, maps, anything that might confirm the intel.
not his call, but he's gonna put a recommendation in for us both. Then there'll be an initiation ceremony of some sort.
So that's it?
Look, some of those guys were on contract for years before training became a rent. You have to be patient. Like what?
Combat encourages experimentation and choice, combining stealth with explosive action. In Rise of the Tomb Raider, no one will experience the game in quite the same way. But that's not all. Before I leave, I wanted to share a sneak peek of the incredible tombs that you can discover when the game launches on November 13th, and tease of the demo we're showing this week at the show. Thanks again, and have a great Gamescom.
Thank you for joining us today. This week, you can stay connected to all the Xbox Gamescom news and announcements on the Xbox Daily live at Gamescom, starting tomorrow. This includes hearing more about the games shown today, the platform features bridging Xbox and Windows, and the hardware and accessory bundles that make your gaming experience even better. Today, we showed you our commitment to deliver amazing experiences that define this generation of gaming and delight millions of gamers around the world. By building the best experiences for gamers and for developers across Xbox One, Windows 10, Microsoft is delivering on our vision for gaming. That vision is focused on the connection to the community of gamers across devices and in our platform and service, but its very foundation is in the games you want to play. This year, we are delivering what we believe is the greatest games lineup in Xbox history, with blockbuster third-party franchises, a diverse set of independent games from ID at Xbox developers, and Xbox 360 games on Xbox One with backward compatibility starting this November. All anchored by the best exclusives available this year. Forza Motorsport 6, Gears of War, Fable Legends, Rare Replay, Gigantic, Rise of the Tomb Raider, and of course, Halo 5 Guardians. And in 2016, the lineup only gets better with exclusive games like Scalebound, Quantum Break, Crackdown 3, ReCore, Gears of War 4, and more. This is the future of gaming at Microsoft. Before we go, we have one more announcement that underscores our commitment to first-party games on Xbox and Windows. Please welcome head of 343 Industries, Bonnie Ross.
...2015 is going to be an amazing year for Xbox One and for gamers. We've teased fans with glimpses of storytelling in Halo 5 Guardians, with the Master Chief being pursued across a troubled galaxy by Spartan Locke. But there are other stories in the Halo universe, stories fans have long demanded we continue. I'm pleased to announce that in fall 2016, on both Xbox One and Windows 10, we will begin the second chapter of a legendary Halo tale. Enjoy.
Windows 10, an Xbox One exclusive.
Come here! This is Red Team! Something hit us! Douglas is down! Immediate evac requested!
Rangkurika